My name's Donald Kennedy. I work with Gordon French, my partner in the Lever and Mulch Partnership. We kill rhododendrons. Scotland's rainforests are incredibly biodiverse. That's probably their most important feature. They are home to countless mosses and lichens and other primitive plants, numerous insects, birds, other animals, all kinds really. They're probably our most biodiverse ecosystem, terrestrial ecosystem in the country. Well, rhododendron is incredibly invasive. Each plant can produce millions of seeds. As soon as they start flowering, really, they're producing millions of tiny seeds, which can be blown on the wind quite considerable distances. They produce tiny little seedlings and that are almost unnoticeable, so that you not know that there's thousands of plants hidden in amongst the lower vegetation. We've come across, very commonly, we come across perhaps 1,000 seedlings in a square meter. They can grow on not just our rainforest, but also our heathland and our bogs, and even on crags, on rocky, in a tiny little rocky crack on a cliff edge. We sometimes call them, the big ones, Loch Ness monsters. You can get a layering branch coming out, swooping, touching the ground, growing again, you know, for 20, 30 meters, much of them under the ground. But they like woodlands for the shelter. They're pretty well protected from frost. They love it when a tree lands on them. No problem, thank you very much. It just presses them into the ground in another 20 places or 100 places. They love it. Once they mature and close canopy underneath a woodland, for example, very little can grow, so they really basically suffocate our rainforests. There's no question about it. The rainforests are our oak woods and our hazel woods and are seriously threatened by it. The only control that we have on them is us, if we kill them. Otherwise, they just continue to invade. It's the rainforest ecosystems that are most important to tackle when rhododendron have invaded, and so they provide us with a long-term employment. There's a huge amount of it. Thoroughness is vital, tackling it on a reasonably big scale. So complete stands need to be done. You can't leave, or one landowner can't do it up to a fence, and the next one and the other one on the other side of the fence not do it because it just seeds back in again. It's really quite an expensive process. You have to keep going back. You can't just do it once. No matter how you attempt to do it, whatever methods you use, it's impossible to eradicate completely at one attempt. I think that's one of the main reasons that many schemes have failed, is because there hasn't been sufficient funding for people to go back and do follow-up operations. These rainforests are absolutely wonderful places. They're wonderful to walk in, to be in. They're full of surprises. They're full of life. Scotland's rainforests are wonderful places.